Landward has a trawlerman special following those who battle to make a living along the west coast. The Prawn Wars is in an hour here on BBC Two Scotland, right after this week's River City.
Short's been put up for a local business award.
Seriously?
Actually, been offered a job in Nepal.
How long would you be away for?
A year.
Please don't go. Stay for me.
I can't decide.
Listen, about last night.
Look, can we just forget it? Because we were both really drunk. I've got to tell Angus that I'm leaving.
You're taking the job?
If I don't, I'm always going to regret it.
Will you make me the happiest guy in the world and be my wife?
Yes.
And I know I'll see you tomorrow, but my mum thought our parents should all meet before the wedding. It might be worth seeing if your folks are up for it. Anyway, I'll catch you tomorrow. Can't wait to see you. Love you long time. Just in ordinary
And thank you for helping to kick off the inaugural Shield Inch Festival. So welcome everybody. My glamorous assistant, Angus Lindsay, will be coordinating the parade, which takes place at 2 o'clock, featuring our very own Festival Queen. And then following that, we'll announce the recipient of the Shield Inch Serves Award.
I can't hear you.
And then finally, we will announce the winners of the most popular stalls.
Best of luck, ladies.
Now, to give us a last song, please welcome back the lovely Hugh and Cry.
I can't hear you.
You say.
What do you mean the float's broken down?
Anyway, we get to the end of the day and we're getting to know each other. And then he tells me that I've helped him tick 2 boxes off his bucket list. He wanted to be with Ginger and somebody's dad's age. I mean, the cheeky him. So that was the end of that day.
And then...
Here, one last thing. So what do you think?
Well, somebody's nicked my Madonna and left me a princess.
I'm a queen. And this dress is itchy.
Oh, quit whining. You've just got to sit there and wave to the crowd. I've got to storm up and make a speech.
You're beautiful. That's what you are. So, how's it going?
Don't worry about it. You might not win.
Angus says it was in the bag.
Really?
Oh, you sound surprised. Here, you voted for yourself, didn't you?
No.
Don't worry about it. You'll know everybody there. Just speak for the heart. All right, you'll be fine. Just stop fretting about it.
Right, well, I'm away. I'll see you all later.
Hang on. I'll chum you. Might find some inspiration.
Hi, Bob. Well, whoa. Back up. Who's broken down? So, why are you telling me? Well, no, I can't think of anybody. No, this late stage.
Should I want you, I don't need your tricks and treats. Should I don't need your administration, your bad determination.
pseudo satisfaction, baby. I said I just can't stand it. I said I do not want it. I said I never need it.
Scarlett doesn't he win? I've told her it's in the bag.
I'll make sure it is.
Is he on the site? Look, just let me know when it's done. All right there, wee man.
Hi. Listen, are you sure you're all right to have him all day?
But after what happened the last time, this street was jam-packed full of people. I'm not letting him out of my sight.
Right. Remember, when you see Madonna, give her a cheer when she's on the big float, right? And when your granny gets a prize. Good boy. Right.
On,
bye.
Pa. Bye.
Look, you sure you don't want to give all this a miss? Head home, put your feet up.
Were you not listening when I was talking to Callum about Madonna and Mama's price? She'd lynch me if I missed this. Anyway, I said to sell I'd help out here.
Fine, but take it easy, OK?
I will. Maybe later on we could get Molly to tell us her fortune. See what married life might hold.
You don't believe all that, surely?
My gran's as psychic as a potato. But it might be a good laugh. I'll just go down my back.
Aye, no bother. Jenny? I thought you went back to tomorrow.
I thought I'd come back early. I didn't want to miss all this. It's brilliant.
Thanks in no small part to your fiancé, but don't tell him I told you that. He must be dying to see him. He was here a minute ago.
Oh, no, don't worry. He'll be up to his eyes. I can catch up with him in a bit. I thought I might lend a hand in the pub if you need me.
Oh, that would be a great help. Thank you.
Eileen, there's one more thing.
Yes, stuck in the middle with you, and I'm wondering what it is you should do. It's too hard to wipe the smile from my face. Losing control, yeah, I'm all over the place. Bounce to the left, jokers to the right. Here I am, stuck in the middle with you.
Hiya. How'd it go?
Well, I wasn't exactly thrilled to see me. Well, the last time we saw each other was rough, so it was always going to be awkward.
But you did say to him he was going to be a grandad, didn't you? For real this time?
Aye. He's really chuffed. He hopes you and the bumper keep him well, and he wishes you his both luck.
And that's it?
Well, we broke the ice in the top. That's a good start.
I know Stevie, but there's no grandparents on my side that are interested. It'd be nice if it was at least one on yours.
Aye, and there will be. Listen, my dad just needs time.
6 months isn't that long. I just really want a wee baby to have a proper family.
Oh, don't worry. Hey, I better get back.
Right, what are you after?
I thought you were going to give up the whole peace doctors thing.
Well, I was going to, but it was just such a great opportunity. I can't walk away from that.
The Paul? Wow. Good for you.
I know it's short notice with the flat and everything.
I don't even think about
it. Could you do me a favour? Don't mention it to your glamorous assistant just yet. I haven't had a chance to.
Yeah, of course.
Eileen?
But I need to go.
How How's it going, ladies?
Very well, thank you. Can I interest you in a reading?
I'd love to, but I'm up to my eyes. I just wanted to check in on you both.
Oh, here, just a quick one, Eileen. Pick a card, any card.
I'm not sure that's how it works.
Wished you. Oh, very apt. This is a very spiritual card, Eileen.
Is that right?
It often means that the subject is about to become much more physically attractive to others, you know? In an amorous way.
Well, I should be so lucky. Thanks for trying. I'll see you later.
So, the secret to this tarot reading is that you just tell people what you think they want to hear.
Elizabeth, I am merely a vessel for the answers to life's burning questions.
What do you mean we've not got a float?
It's broken down on the M6.
Everything on schedule?
Aye, brilliant.
She's going to get off her nut. She's been bringing this parade up all week.
But this was all your stupid idea. I told you we should have went to a proper rental place.
Right. Right, well, we've got 2 hours to locate, transport and decorate a float.
We? Oh, you're the parade coordinator, not me.
Aye, so I've got loads to do. I'm meant to be liaising with the stallholders, gathering the votes.
So delegate.
Find a float. Come on. This is your wee sister's big day. Your whole family's going to be watching, proud as punch. Do you want to spoil it for them?
You find a float, and I'll find the decorations. But you owe me one.
Stevie.
I thought you wanted back to tomorrow.
Nice to see you too. I came back early to help out. You're welcome. What's the matter with your face?
Nothing.
Have we not seen the party going on out there?
Leave it as any.
Are you still in a huff because Stella won't let you be Fireman Sam? Because I was thinking you could become a stripper if you buffed up a bit, and at least that way you'd still get to wear the uniform.
I said leave it.
I'm only messing. Whatever's going on, no need to take it out on me.
Look, I'm not in the mood, all right? I've got enough to deal with.
Well, it's not my fault your life's not shaping up.
Oh, is that right? Says the medical student who's graduated to barmaid and then flushed her dreams down the toilet as soon as somebody proposed.
You don't need to concern yourself with my future. But if I ever want career advice from a failure, you'll be the first person I turn to.
Is this it?
Peeled in.
She was talking off a little bit glass here.
Let's go check out some stalls.
You can see why I'd be dragged out here.
Ugh, lighten up, you. It's a family day out. That's what we all need.
Come on!
You should take it a present. Excuse me, you couldn't tell me the way to the tall ship pub, could you? I meant to be with my sister there and she gave me directions over the phone. What is this fan? Now I'm completely lost.
It's just round the corner.
You'll be darling. Nice flowers, by the way.
It's not like you to walk away from an argument, unless you've won it.
Is that your idea and an apology?
Is it yours?
Could be. Congratulations on that last dig. Bullseye.
What is going on? Are Stella and the baby okay?
Oh, aye, they're fine.
What is it then? I thought you'd be loving all this.
Saw my dad this morning.
Right.
You wish Stella and the baby the best of luck. Says they're going to need it with a waste of space like me.
That is not fair.
Well, it's not wrong, though, is it? I broke up the family, ended his marriage. He's got every reason to think I'll screw this up too.
Of course you won't.
Stella thinks we can be this big, happy family. How am I meant to tell her my dad's not even interested?
maybe in time, though.
Let's get back inside. Molly, I really don't have time for this.
This one. This is a card about strength.
I can see that.
What?
It's written on the card.
Oh, this one. This, the tower. This card is about change. But change is not always a bad thing. Trying to stop it could lead to terrible consequences.
Is there any good news in here?
There you are. I see a very attractive young lady. You have asked her a question and she has said yes.
Molly, everybody knows that now. I don't have time. I just came here voting for him.
This card tells me that yous have been separated, but today you will have a happy reunion.
Ah, well, you're wrong there, because then he's no back to tomorrow.
The cards do not lie, my son.
No, but you do.
Have faith in the powers. Ignore them at your peril.
You're at it. Are you just making this up, or what?
Well, it just so happens I just saw the lassie no 5 minutes ago.
You serious?
See for yourself. Hey! What have I crossed my palm with silver?
Cheers, doll. Listen, let's have a proper catch-up when all this madness is finished.
You're on.
How was your week with your mum and dad?
Oh. It reminded me why I only visit twice a year.
So how'd they react to the wedding news? Look, don't worry about it. They'll come round.
Oh, hiya.
Sorry, pal.
Cheers.
All right, mate. All right. What can I do for you? Is Zinny here? Well, I know she's not due back to tomorrow, but...
Oh, she was here a minute ago, aye.
Really? She never told me she was coming back.
Maybe she wanted to surprise you. I'll let her know you're looking for her.
All right, cheers, buddy.
What was that all about?
Come on, Mum, this is not why we're here.
Oh, she'll keep. I just want to try a few of these first. Go and check your blonde sister. What is that?
Well, that is a delicious steak and onion bhaji pie. And that is leek and Bombay aloo.
Aloo? Mm-hmm. Oh, no. That's spicy, isn't it? No, I don't touch spicy or leeks. It gives me terrible wind. But terrible, I mean boofing. What's this?
Well, that is a Goan-style chicken curry with apricots, so it's one of your five a day right there.
Five what?
Would you like to buy anything?
These places, I don't think so, darling.
Oh. Eileen Hamilton. Or should I say Councillor Donaghy? I've advised Peel for you all morning.
I couldn't believe it when I saw your name on the list.
I well believed it when I saw yours. All this, down to you, eh? I wouldn't have expected anything less.
Angus is already planning the wedding. He was in here last night with a bride magazine looking for ideas for his mood board. He doesn't know?
I haven't had a chance to talk to him. I've been away and...
You could have phoned him.
I need to tell him face to face.
You're not going to text dump him.
I am not dumping him. It's only for a year.
Oh, but you're going to do both? Marry a man, go to Nepal?
Yes.
Do you not think Angus should have a say in this? You need to tell him.
I need a chance to work out what I'm going to say. I just want to go and do one stint with Peace Doctors while I still can. I won't be able to do that when I'm married with kids and I'm...
Trapped. Like me.
I was going to say have responsibilities. This is my last chance for an adventure.
You should be speaking to Angus about this, not me.
Any more punch?
Aye, I'll go make another batch.
So, banker to baker, that is some reinvention.
People like bakers.
That's true.
Listen, talking about Malcolm, he's a good man.
Yeah, thanks.
So I see the old home set up for rent.
Yeah, it's been empty for a couple of weeks. Are you interested?
Oh, don't tempt me. Look, it's amazing being back, you know. Things are different, but Some things haven't changed at all.
Aileen, we talk.
Oof, you're a public await.
Well, we should have a proper catch-up now you know where to find me.
What about tonight?
Well, I'll be busy with this lot till 7.
You're worth the wait.
OK.
Yeah?
Well, I'll see you later.
OK.
Mum, I need some dinner money.
You've already had some.
What is this?
It's a cinnamon swirl.
Oh.
£2. She's at the pub.
Yeah, that's where she works. She'll be busy, there's no rush.
Mum, I need to finish my assignment by Wednesday. Can we just go and say hello?
You need a break for this schoolwork. You're 17, you should be having fun. Come on.
Helen?
I like your dress. Do you want some cake?
Excuse me, you going to pay for that? Hey! Kids? You've got to be kidding me. It's a piece of junk.
It's no. It still works. You've got to clean up and some fairy lights and it'll be...
Bogging?
Look, beggars can't be choosers. It's either that or a horse and cart for the sanctuary.
I knew you'd make an arse of this. I can't let my wee sister go in that. It's no safe.
She'll be strapped in.
My mat is going to kill me.
Oh, aye. And young Kylie's going to give me a pat in the back. They're only charging £30. And that included delivery, so... Just do what you can do.
Me?
Aye. That was the deal I find the float. There's the float.
No way. I'm supposed to be having lunch with Ellie, but I've got to go and check out the stalls.
Why don't you go and find Zinny?
She back?
Aye. She's not answering her phone, but...
Well, you can find Zinny once the float's ready.
And you and Ellie can go and stuff your faces once the float's ready. Fine. Date together, come on.
Well done, Cal.
Yeah.
For you. Well done, Yui. Big gold medal. Oh.
Huh? You're done.
Oh, yeah. It's no worries. Just take your best shot, mate.
Okay. Wake up. Make sure it's cleaned up, okay, and thoroughly. Not a drop. I don't want any of this coming back on me, all right? Hey, let's go and get sweets.
How are you, goals?
Not bad.
Fancy making yourself a wee fiver and jumping in for 10 minutes?
Look, I'm really sorry, but I'll be as quick as I can.
Don't worry about it. This place is crazy anyway. I couldn't get away. Just go and sort that boat, right?
Look at you and your wee pocket rocket. Still, it's a step up for that big dafty buster.
Come here, you! Oh!
What are you doing here?
I came to see you.
What do you want?
Well, what sort of welcome's that for you, big sister?
Let's just call it the voicey experience.
Oh, that's charming, that is. I've dragged the kids across the town to see you and sample the delights of your precious shield and you know it's festival glory. Any chance of a cheeky wee photo?
Oh, come on. You still hiding?
Busted. Listen, I'm sorry about earlier. I really wasn't trying to say I thought you were trapped.
Look, just don't worry about it.
You know, I've been thinking about what your dad said.
What?
He doesn't know you. Not anymore.
You see, the Stevie he is talking about is long gone. You're a different guy now. Stronger, braver. You were a rock for Nicole, and you've seen Stella through some really tough times. And when I was... the whole Jamie thing. You were there for me. And through all of that, you were fighting your own battles day in, day out. So your dad knows nothing.
I will see. Nice try.
What?
Putting this off isn't going to make it any easier.
I know.
Come on. Good luck.
Can you just make sure there is a gallon of that for when I get back?
Aye, I'll make one specially.
I've lived here for ages. You've never bothered your fat ass to visit me here before.
You can talk.
So, where's the other two?
What?
Drew and Ruby, your kids.
I know who they are, thanks. Go and find them, would you? Make sure they're not up to any mischief.
Right. So what are you really doing here? Right. Look, I need a babysitter for a few hours. Oh, Jenny's got an assignment, so she'll be at the library. You know what she's like?
It's my mother, well, Kev.
Oh, he said sorry. Oh, look, it's a works night out the night, and, well, he really wants me there for moral support, and...
I can't. I've only got a wee room in somebody else's flat.
Oh, I'll be back by 11, promise. Here, look, take the kids out for a meal. There's that swanky place down the road.
The Oyster?
Aye. Oh, come on, Ellie. The kids have really missed you. A couple hours for the Aunt Ellie, please.
Look, it doesn't necessarily mean anything bad. It just means you have to trust your instincts. If you think somebody's at it, they probably are.
Okay. Thank you, Gran.
Just mind your back, Hen.
Thing is, I don't pay overheads. So it keeps the prices down.
Mm-hmm. It's just I don't think I'd fancy getting a blow dry in a van in full view of street.
Oh, it's a mobile salon. Air conditioning, luxury fittings.
It's on wheels. It's a van.
And besides, we already have a very successful hairdresser in Shieldbridge.
Well, competition never hurt anyone.
Very true. I might think about it. A change is as good as a rest. So, would you like to know how it'll all work out for you?
Well, as long as it's good news. Follow me to your future.
This is a nightmare, man. We're never going to have this done in time.
Still got 50 minutes.
We need more stuff. My man's loft.
What?
All right.
Hi, Bob.
Hiya.
Hey.
Oh. I missed you. Why did you not tell me you were back?
I knew you'd be busy with the festival and I wanted to surprise you.
So how was it with your folks?
It was fine.
Why are you back so early? Did they give you a hard time about no meeting me before I popped the question?
Oh, it was okay. But can you get away?
I've missed you as well, but can you not control yourself for a couple of hours? What's up?
How long is Bob going to be?
I don't know, no long how.
Can we just pop home for 5 minutes? I need to talk to you.
Ah, sure.
Oh,
sorry. Oh, no, you go that way.
Thanks.
Eileen, this award, this speech, how long is it supposed to be?
Right, the votes haven't even counted yet.
Aye, but just in case, you know, so I can be prepared.
Well, there's no rule about how long, just a few minutes.
Few minutes?
Just tell people what Shieldinch means to you.
It's where I live.
Where's Madonna?
She's with you.
She's with you?
No, she's with you.
Oh, she was with Kelly Marie at the cake stand, oh, 10 minutes ago.
All right, I'm going to find her.
Right, see you.
Oh, sorry.
Hi.
Tomorrow. You were supposed to phone them and tell them you're not going.
Well, I did. I couldn't. I just needed time to think.
Think about what? Us? When I asked, you said yes.
And I meant it. I still do mean it.
So you're just going to go and live in Nepal and me and Shield Inch? How does that work?
I know it's not going to be easy. But this is the chance of a lifetime. We can still get married.
This is no way to start a marriage. Thousands of miles apart.
I get 3 trips back a year, 6 weeks leave. So I was thinking on one of the trips home, we could get married. Or at the end of the contract.
I can't believe you. This is a joke, right?
Angus, please wait.
What? So you can try and convince me, but you can't. Zinny, this isn't how it's supposed to be.
You know, I think you might have the gift after all, Molly.
Oh, you don't need to tell me that. Must you encourage her?
I've just bumped into my old high school sweetheart, AJ.
Oh.
Yeah, he was my first proper boyfriend. He lived next door, you know, in Alan Lindsay's old house. Mm. He's asked me to meet him for a drink later.
Told you. Mm-hmm. Well, I hope you're going to go. You deserve a bit of romance.
Yeah, well, I'll make time for AJ.
Oh, ye of little faith. Now, here's a man who needs to know what the future holds for him if ever I saw one.
All right.
Lenny Murdoch, Lenny Murdoch.
Sounds about right.
Oh, council. When's your road reopened?
You'll be guided out by the stewards after the parade.
Is the council going to compensate me for lost earnings here? I mean, my guys can't get near the office. I'm parked half a mile away.
You'd know the answers if you bothered to come to any of the meetings. You having fun, Callum?
Yeah.
You see, that's what it's all about. You can try, Lenny, but you're not going to spoil today for me.
Well, what do you mean, what problem? Now, can I talk to him? Call you back. One part.
My Madonna, would you run about thieving?
No, she wouldn't do that.
I think I know more than my sister. Besides, there's no many kids kicking about dresses if they fell off the Christmas tree.
Well, who was she with?
I don't know, I've never seen her before.
Where'd they go?
I rigged it up that way.
Yeah, I just saw it at Patrick's store a couple of minutes ago.
If I see her, I'll tell her to come to the shop, all right?
Cheers.
We've only got half an hour. This is the last thing I need.
Just you concentrating your speech, all right, and I'll make sure Madonna's ready for the parade.
That's what you said this morning. You're not doing a great job so far, are you?
You can't just turn up and steal someone's customers.
Hairdressing's like marriage. You can't steal something that doesn't want to be stolen.
Oh, so you've no guilt about taking my livelihood?
I'm not taking anything. And why are you so scared of a little competition?
I'm not scared.
Because from what I hear, you don't have to be.
What?
Everyone seems really fond of you.
Aye, they are. Because I'm part of this community, I put the others in.
Come on, you can't blame me for trying.
Madonna!
This is Ruby. She's my new best friend.
Got a bunch of stuff in my ma's. What's that?
But Lenny, it was you that asked to have him all day.
Yeah, but something else came up. Look, we've seen all there is to see, haven't we, Pop?
Yeah.
Didn't it take long?
He was looking forward to spending the day with you. And you go and dump him as soon as you get a better offer.
We might have had a great time. There's nothing left for him to see or do. He wants to get home. See you later, pal.
Bye.
See? No harm done. What is it?
Have you got anything going down the day?
How?
Well, it's just that I saw a guy hanging about earlier on. I just wanted to make sure everything was kosher. You know, with Cal and everything.
Why, you're not paying attention. Cal's with his ma, he's fine.
So you got nothing going down?
What's it to you?
Well, I know that stuff a couple of weeks ago with that lawyer, lassie.
It's not any day we are, OK? I'm just having a wee bit of a clear out. Best you don't know. Huh? Hey, Jimmy. This guy, still about?
I don't think so, but I'll keep my eyes on him. Scarlett, have you found her? She's what?
Ow!
I thought she looked good.
We don't get him, Egoy!
Well, your mum and dad don't wonder where you are.
Oh, this is a pure disaster! I haven't written my speech, and Madonna's been dragged through a mitten.
Right, leave Madonna to me. We just need to think outside the box. I mean, she won't have the look that we were hoping for, but maybe it'll be better. You write that speech and leave this one to me.
So still be the star of the show.
Oh, I'll get that.
Oh, what am I going to do, Jimmy?
Well, how far have you got?
This is pure amazing. I'm so shocked, I can't believe it. Well, I can't let them know that I know.
Keep going.
Right. Shocked. Can't believe it. Thank you, everyone who has voted for me. You as are all brilliant. All of yous. Especially my brilliant man, Jimmy, and all my brilliant Waynes. But most of all, you, my customers. You are the best. Shield Inch is the best! It's rubbish, isn't it? You do it for me.
What?
Aye. Will you always tell me you're still worrying about it? I'll just be like the Oscars. You go up and accept it on my behalf. And you can do my speech for me, and I'll help Robbie with Madonna.
Honestly, there's no need. I've got it covered.
Look, I'm sure you do, but I just thought you could use these.
Oh, these are brilliant. These are perfect. Right, let's get this in sorted.
Yes.
I don't want you to go.
I know. I'm being so selfish even asking you.
And the thought of you being out there terrifies me. I mean, even if it was Switzerland.
Well, the last I heard, they didn't need humanitarian aid.
But Nepal?
You think I'm horrible?
I think you're incredible. For being brave enough to even think about it, but that's you. Fearless, smart.
I will never get this chance again. And it would be such a good experience for whatever I do when I get back.
I get that. I know that now's the time you need to take chances like that. You can't do it when we've got kids and a mortgage. I know that. I thought we could be happy together.
And we will be.
I love you.
And I love
you. So, if this is what it takes, if this is something that you need to do, then I shouldn't stand in your way.
You're okay with it?
No. No, but that's what you want. I've never been to Nepal. So go. Get out of your system and I'll be here when you get back. And then we can go on with the rest of our lives. Right, I better go and get this show on the road. I'll speak to you later.
Hey folks, I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to shut for a wee while. Come on, shift it. Like, don't worry, it's just until after the parade. Just let you back in, come on. The stalls are still open for all your libation needs anyway. Hey, big chap. Cheers. How'd it go?
Says he'll wait for me. If it's what I want.
Really? Well, that's a good thing, isn't it?
Is there any of that punch left?
So, how's your stall getting on?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Exceeded all hopes, yeah.
Well, I'm just checking we're still on for that drink tonight.
Absolutely. I've been looking forward to all day.
Okay.
Eileen, this is my wife, Annie.
Ah, nice to meet you. I've heard a lot about you.
Yeah, nice to meet you too. I hope you're enjoying yourself.
Yeah, very much so. Well done for organising all this. It's fabulous.
Thanks. Right, well, oh, it's almost show time, so I should...
Of course. See you in the ship later.
Yeah.
I must be somewhere better than that. Spit and sawdust dump. I mean, is there not a wine bar just down there?
It's actually Eileen's pub. She's the owner.
Oh, I am so sorry. I actually haven't even been in it yet, so it'd be really lovely to see you there.
Okay, bye.
What?
Oh, come on, please. I don't want your money. Let me pop working out tonight. You can't expect me just to drop everything. Take him, will you?
What?
Are you in trouble?
I missed you.
But we're going to have to miss her some more. We're going to have to head home soon.
But I want to see Madonna become Queen of the Fairies.
Oh, Aunt Ellie's too busy.
Like, get a rest, too. Please, can we stay for the parade?
Okay.
Oh, thank you! Thank you!
I need to get back to my work.
Okay, to what?
Oh, we're going to have tea together at back to your cafe over there. Where's the loo? Right. Go get yourselves an ice cream and we'll watch the parade for that fountain over there. Hi, darling. Did you get my suitcase?
I'm so sorry. Last thing you need is a hysterical female blubbing on your shoulder.
Don't be daft. Oh. You listen to me whinging earlier. Oh. Yeah.
I should be so happy. Angus is giving me everything I want. What if I don't want it? I do love him.
Do you like to spend the rest of your life with him?
Angus was there for me at the worst time of my life and when I needed someone kind and thoughtful.
Whoa, hold on, Zinny, listen to me. You can't spend the rest of your life with somebody because you're grateful.
Oh, what's wrong with me?
There's nothing wrong with you.
No, I've got the perfect man. No, he loves me and he supports me and he's funny and clever and cute and...
But?
I'm not ready. I want to get married and I want to have kids, but not yet. And not with him. Oh my God. What am I gonna do? He's gonna give me everything I want and I'm gonna throw it back in his face.
Yeah, come on, it's all right. All right, calm down. Zenny, come here, pal. Hey, come on. Hey, come on. All right.
Yeah, well, I'm on my way. And don't do anything else till I get there.
The plane leaves in a couple of hours. I've got to be there.
Can I help you, darling? I need drivers.
Where the hell are you?
I'm the owner.
Well, here's a bit of business advice. A cab firm needs drivers.
Yeah? The road's shut.
Well, it'll be open in a couple of minutes.
Come on, tube just round the corner. Off you go.
I'll never make it in the tube. I'll sit here and wait.
No, you won't. Let me just give you a wee warning here. This is not a day you mess with me.
See with Stella, you just know.
What, that I love her? Aye.
That you want to be with her forever.
Totally. Well, it's still scary and all that, you know what I mean? The baby stuff. And... yeah, it'd be like, sake.
Well, we're good mates, aren't we? Or am I being presumptuous? Presumptuous.
Easy for you to say. Listen, I'm going to miss you, pal.
Yeah. I'll miss you too. A lot. I'm sorry for all the times I was a total bitch to you.
Psst. Whatever. It's kind of sexy, to be honest with you.
Well, you thought I was sexy.
Of course. All the guys do.
You just always such pain, just winding me up. You did it on purpose.
You better believe it. It's far too easy.
You're such a wee Ned. One day, it's like I saw you and you'd grown up. You know, you're like solid and responsible and so cheeky as ever. But you see, your dad. He doesn't know the guy that you've become.
Solid and responsible.
And hot. But don't go getting a big head. Right, I better go and do some packing before we reopen the bar.
Take your time. I've got it covered.
Are you trying to get rid of me?
No. Yeah, in fact, you know what? Just make sure you come back here and say goodbye, all right? Maybe I could volunteer.
What?
Maybe one of the charities that build schools and that, I could do that. And then I could be nearer.
You'd need to learn Nepalish. Napoleon. No, what is it?
Nepalese.
Aye. You up for that?
I don't know.
Look, you just need to sit down together and talk it through properly.
Maybe we'll. Later. Suppose that'll need to do it.
Maybe get a bit of tinfoil for that bit.
Aye, it's worth a shot.
I'll ask you at the pub.
Right. That's different.
Well, it's different.
It's as good as it's gonna get.
We're gonna be late.
What happened to the tinfoil? But never mind, we better get this thing into position. Your mum's just text. Madonna's on her way.
Please. Don't regret it.
Like Zinny. I love Stella, I should never...
And I love Angus, but... This was just our way of saying goodbye. So nobody knows, and nobody ever has to know. Hey. I should go.
So what you got? I mean, what are you going to do
about Angus?
No.
Find him. Break his heart. It's Stevie. I know you don't believe it right now, but you are a good man. And you're going to be a great dad.
Zinny. You look after yourself, pal, all right?
Out.
No.
I'm serious.
You and me both, pal.
Don't test my patience, lady, okay? I don't have time for this.
Oh, come on. Please, you're leaving anyway. Can I catch a wee lift? Oh, come on. I just need a wee break, a wee bit of sun. I work so hard day after day looking after my three wains. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love my three wains, but it's hard, you know? Oh, come on, I'm so tired. Please, I just need to get to the airport.
Get dropped at nearest taxi rank, and that's it.
Thank you so much.
And now we get to our first ever Shield and Serves Award.
Keep your hair on, I'll be there in 40 minutes.
This award is given to someone who drops spirit and commitment to our community. Can I have the envelope, please? And the Shield and Serves to Scarlett Mullen and Scarlett's one-stop shop.
cab now.
You said you'd take me a taxi ride.
Look, the cab now!
Get back! Get back, everybody! Move away! Get back! Get away from here! Get back! Go on, go on, go on! Move away! Get back! No! No!
Can you hear me? Hello? Hello, can you hear me? Can you grab my hand? If you can hear me, squeeze my hand. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? If you can hear me, squeeze my hand.
Where's the
cannula?
I need to be
left.
She knows
you're here.
Sir, can you hear me? Over here!
Well, we don't know that it was a bomb.
It was Lenny Murdoch's car. It was a bomb.
I've just survived a terrorist attack and now I'm being accused of abandoning my kids.
Well, the doctors would like you to come down to the hospital.
Why?
There's a chance Lenny's not going to make it.
What?
I'm sorry.
And a taster of next Tuesday's episode of River City in just a moment, when the aftermath of events unfolds. Well, later, chasing the ghostly bonefish and tackling Cuba's violent storms, seven anglers face Earth's wildest waters at eight. But the prawn wars are next.
Get back, everybody! Move away!
Sorry.
And stop fighting this. What have you got to live for?
River City, Tuesday at 8 on BBC One Scotland and on HD.